Ohio cops brutally attack a black female during an arrest. Here's a video. All right, you see this attack. Okay, it's about to happen. And it's so gruesome, we literally cannot show the whole thing. All right. I'm going to give you some significant background as to what happened here. All right. Very sad. Let's put up the picture for mass. All right, this gives you an illustration of what was happening. These two Butler Township, Ohio cops are now under investigation after a witness recorded the vicious assault during this black woman's arrest. The woman has been identified as Latinka Hancock. Ms. Hancock is pictured there. At the start of this soundless video, Hancock can be seen speaking to the officers as she tries to push them away. A cop on the left, identified by Butler Township Chief of Police John Porter as Tom Zellers, appears to be pointing a stun gun in his right hand at Ms. Hancock. Meanwhile, an officer to the right, identified as Sergeant Todd Stanley, holds her arm and shoulder. At one point, Ms. Hancock appears to wave her hands around, and Stanley punches her in the face multiple times until Ms. Hancock falls back on the hood of the cruiser. The officers then hold Ms. Hancock against the car as Officer Zellers handcuffs her. So it led to the incident. Ryan Julison, the media contact for Hancock's attorney, told the Daily Beast in a written statement that the incident happened after Ms. Hancock received an incorrect Big Mac order from McDonald's. Julison wrote that Ms. Hancock tried to rectify the situation with restaurant employees who ended up calling the police on her. Per the body cam footage, Hancock told the officer she refused to take a dollar to give me 30 cents after I paid for extra cheese. All right, minor, obviously. Ms. Hancock said about the disagreement with the McDonald's worker, which prompted the call by workers to police. She got an attitude because I requested a refund and called the police because she didn't want to give me the money back. According to her attorney, Ms. Hancock was leaving the restaurant. Butler Township Police confronted Ms. Hancock during the incident. She was then punched repeatedly in the head, sending her to the hospital where she was diagnosed with a head injury. Ultimately, Ms. Hancock was charged with failure to provide identification and with resisting arrest. That's according to the local outlet WHIO TV. Let's put a picture of the chief up. Chief Porter said that Stanley, the cop, has now been placed on leave while an investigation is conducted against him for his conduct you just saw. He stated the investigation started due to hate mail and messages received over the incident. He also noted that some of Stanley's days off are part of the leave. He also said if improper conduct is found, the findings of the investigation will include a recommendation for discipline. He explained that officers are trained to use force for personal protection. And he showed a diagram of acceptable police responses to civilians. However, he said he would not comment on the appropriateness of the police officer's actions until the entire investigation is complete. Porter said officers were responding to a criminal trespass complaint from the restaurant at the time Ms. Hancock was arrested. He said the officers initially tried to calm her down. Certain incidents you cannot de-escalate, Porter said during Wednesday's press conference. And let me say this, you're right, there are certain incidents you may not be able to de-escalate, but there's no criminal aspect here if she left the property. According to the report, she was walking away from the property. She was not at the property. She had left the property or was leaving the property. All right, what is the criminal issue here? All right, there's an argument about a Big Mac and cheese and 30 cents. Okay, two people got into an argument. The restaurant employee called the police, the person leaves. Police come, they make things infinitely worse. Now, you may disagree with how Ms. Hancock dealt with the situation at McDonald's if you believe the narrative as presented. That's not the issue. That's not the issue. Whatever led to the encounter is not really the issue. Part of it is part of it because there's a question about why would you call the police on somebody due to an argument at McDonald's? Why would you call the cops? Okay, you called them. They come. She's already off the property or at least leaving the property as the report says. The police come and do they engage in their sworn duty? What is their sworn duty? You see, their certificate says they are peace officers. That's what the certificate says when they actually get certified. Peace officers, they bring peace. Did it look as if they were bringing peace to you? It looked to me like they were arresting some mad felony, a mad felon who just could not comply for anything in the world. Punching a woman in the face like that and then deciding, well, we're going to charge her with resisting arrest and a criminal trespass. Remember, none of those charges are felonies. Also, there's a dynamic here which has to be highlighted. They do have a duty to report in Ohio. If one cop sees another cop doing something ridiculous, those jurisdictions are supposed to report crimes by cops. Nobody reported it. It was a bystander, a person who happened to have a recording device, who saw it, recorded it, and released it. Now there's an investigation. That cop is on leave, at least for now. All right. Also, following the press conference, Porter's presser, let's go to the attorney, Michael Wright. He actually spoke to the media on Ms. Hancock's behalf, calling it, and I quote, an incredibly sad day when my client's life has been upended over a piece of cheese. See, Wright continued by saying, Sergeant Stanley deserves to be fired and charged with assault with his outrageous overreaction. Wright also claimed the officers were looking for a fight rather than looking for de-escalation. And I concur. Here's another dynamic. The person who you saw punching the woman, he's a supervisor. Yeah, he's a supervisor. He's a guy in charge of other cops. He's the person that shows you the ropes when you first get hired as a police officer. See, that is the great cultural exchange that's adverse to the policy of the police department. All right, David, thoughts here?
Well, a couple of things. I sort of wonder if this woman had been white instead of black, would the police have come on that strong? So that's my first concern. Secondly, failure to produce ID, you need to be able to reasonably articulate a reasonable articulable suspicion of what's the underlying crime. Was the underlying crime that she was outraged over a missing piece of cheese? I mean, that's ridiculous. So they probably didn't have justification anyway to ask for her ID. She probably said, no, I'm not gonna give you ID, and it escalated there. And yet they're supposed to de-escalate these tensions. And the courts have long held that you cannot use force. You cannot use a taser, you cannot use a gun, you cannot use physical violence force unless you believe the person that you are arresting, unless you believe they are a danger to themselves, to the officers, to anybody else. Was this woman a safety threat to anybody? It didn't look that way. It just looked like maybe she mouthed off, which she's entitled to do under the First Amendment, and they didn't like it.
You're damn right. You have the right to be a jerk if you choose to. It's a constitutional operation. It's protected by the Constitution. But routinely, we see that officers will utilize their own free speech to incarcerate you.